I wanted to come here and see what struggles and problems other startups might face. And I was also particularly interested in seeing what kind of financing venture capital firms would offer.
A successful entrepreneur definitely needs patience. A lot of patience, a lot of time for developing your venture. You start up with a product, you create something great, you work on it day and night, and then guess what? In the beginning, nobody cares. You have to take the time to show it to people, you have to take the time to develop it properly, and that requires a great deal of time and patience.
My first advice for students which are interested in startups is to meet other students which are also interested in startups, or other people which are interested in startups. And they did the first step. They're here at Frankfurt School Startup Night, and here are so many interested people, 450 people. That's my first advice. Second advice is to test your business model in front of investors, business angels, to get the first feedback from the market. And afterwards, advice three, you have to do it. These are your homeworks.
We as Emma and as a Frankfurt-based startup, it's very important for us to be part of local events. And since we have a lot of employees and our team mostly comes from the greater Frankfurt area, it's very important to us to also be present at great local universities. In the early stages of a startup, it's very important to learn how to fail. So learning from the mistakes and then adapting what you're doing and doing it better and then failing and improving again.
Well, the panel discussion gave some very interesting insights about the pros and cons of venture capital funding and also ICO funding.
Yeah, so if a student is actually interested in a startup, my best advice would be do an internship in a startup first before you're planning to start your own company. You will probably at some point in time be very close to run out of money, so funds will always be short, so you need to be sure where to identify the next investors and how to convince them. You must not get frustrated, you need to be persistent and to follow up, to believe in your own idea and your own project, because if you're not fully convinced about your own idea, it's hard and impossible to convince anybody else to invest in your project. They want to build a product which really reaches the market and to have a B2C startup where really I can interact with my own users and improve the product in a user-centric way. And this was really my motivation to quit my old corporate job. So I've taken a significant cut in my salary, but a significant improvement in my overall happiness.